Today I am going to discuss with you various contraindications of tooth extractions. These are the underlying medical conditions or the state of the patient that can lead to intraoperative or postoperative complications if extraction is attempted without proper planning. There are two types of contraindication. One is systemic contraindication, second is local contraindication. There are one more classification. One is absolute contraindication, second is relative contraindication. Absolute contraindication means you cannot extract the tooth at any condition before the management of the underlying condition. In case of relative contraindication, depending on the risk and benefit, we can plan extraction in same visit or at next visit. There is only one absolute contraindication of tooth extraction, that is AV malformation or hemangioma. Systemic contraindication, as the name suggests, there are the medical conditions involving the patient's central nervous system, cardiovascular system or endocrine system, etc. And local contraindications are the conditions present at or around the tooth that needs to be extracted. Now, why one should avoid extraction in an uncontrolled diabetic patient? Why there is delayed healing and more chances of infection? It's because of reduced production of growth and healing hormones, decreased production and repair of blood vessels, reduced collagen synthesis and impaired chemotaxis and phagocytosis, that leads to delay in healing and more chances of infection as compared to normal patient. That's why we should avoid extraction in a patient of diabetes mellitus with uncontrolled sugar level. Now, second medical condition in which we should delayed or plan our extraction, that is hyperthyroidism. Why one should delayed extraction in hyperthyroidism? It's because of thyrotoxicosis and thyroid storm. Thyroid storm represents the extreme manifestation of thyrotoxicosis. It is a true endocrine emergency. If there is a precipitating event or condition that can transform the patient to a life-threatening situation. Now, symptoms of thyrotoxicosis: tachycardia, atrial fibrillation, fever, excessive sweating, nausea, vomiting, excessive shaking, confusion, loss of consciousness and coma. Syncope can occur due to an acute central nervous system reaction to mental stress induced by dental treatment. Thyrotoxicosis is an absolute contraindication for use of adrenaline in local anesthetic solution, because it can lead to atrial fibrillation and cardiac arrest. Osteoporosis is a condition that causes bone to become weak and brittle. So if we do extraction in such patient who are not taking any treatment, can lead to bone fracture. Second condition, the patients who are on bisphosphonate therapy for osteoporosis, like alendronate, risedronate, ibendronate and zoledronic acid. These medications help to keep your bones healthy and lower the risk of bone fracture. Unfortunately, it can have a negative effect on bone healing after injury induced after tooth extraction, and can lead to a condition called as medicine-related osteonecrosis of the jaw. So this kind of patient should be referred to an experienced maxillofacial surgeon for their management. Fourth condition, chronic renal disorder. Patients with chronic renal disorder have built-in vitamin D metabolism and also abnormal calcium and phosphate balance. All these conditions lead to impaired healing and more chances of infection as compared to normal patient. If the patient is taking dialysis, extraction should be done after the 24 hours of the dialysis so that the effect of heparin wears off and bleeding is arrested easily. Fifth condition, malignant disease like leukemia and lymphoma. In this patient, there are more chances of hemorrhage, chances of infection and delayed wound healing. And in case of lymphoma, sometimes leads to non-healing. Now, sixth condition, uncontrolled cardiac disease, out of which hypertension is most common. In case of if patient blood pressure is very high, that will lead to excessive bleeding if extraction is attempted. Second condition, myocardial infarction. If your patient has history of myocardial infarction, one should avoid elective treatment for at least 6 months and also emergency treatment in hospital setup so that if complication arise, you can be managed in the hospital setup. Now coming on the seventh condition, blood disorders. Blood disorder like hemophilia are prone for excessive bleeding. Anemic patients are susceptible candidate for delayed healing and infection. Now coming on to the patients on medications, should be treated with cautions. Like if your patient has a history of corticosteroid therapy, this is one important rule of two related to steroid therapy. What is rule of two? If a patient had undergone steroid therapy within last 2 years for more than 2 weeks and more than 20 milligram of corticosteroid, then he or she is a potential candidate for adrenal crisis due to adrenal atrophy while doing extraction. For doing extraction in this kind of patient, either double the dose of steroid if he or she is already taking steroid, or give him or her 20 milligram of prednisolone on day of surgery. If the patient is on aspirin therapy due to his cardiac or other condition, one should consult patient physician before stopping the aspirin. As we all know, it binds irreversibly with platelets and interferes in clot formation. Ideally, it should be stopped 7 days prior to the treatment, but it can be best decided by patient physician based on the patient cardiac status. Either we can stop it or we have to use some alternative like heparin therapy. Patients on immunosuppressive drugs are potentially candidate for delayed healing and more chances of infection. As you all know, cancer chemotherapy drugs are anti-metabolic drugs that can lead to delayed healing or chances of wound infection are there. So one should avoid extraction in a patient on cancer chemotherapy for at least for 30 days of the last chemotherapy. Pregnancy is considered as a contraindication. Second trimester is considered relatively safe as compared to first and third trimester. In case of first trimester, there are chances of congenital deformity and miscarriage. And in third trimester, it's difficult for the patient to sit on the chair and chances of there for the patient to go into the syncope. If a pregnant patient go into the syncope, the best position to keep her in left lateral position. Now coming on to the local contraindication. First local contraindication is previous radiation treatment. Radiation treatment for head and neck malignancy, one should avoid extraction for at least 1 year as it can lead to osteoradionecrosis. There is one rule called a golden period. That is within 30 days of the therapy started, in which one can perform emergency dental extraction, but not after that. Second local contraindication is hemangioma. As we all know, it's a blood vessel tumor. If extraction is attempted unplanned in a patient with history of hemangioma, that can lead to profuse bleeding and sometimes to very serious outcome, even patient death. Third, malignant tumor. If we attempted extraction in a patient suffering from malignant tumor in that area, that can lead to dissemination of the cells and metastasis. If the tooth associated with tumor is improperly treated, it can result in recurrence. acute oral infections like acute pericoronal abscess or pericoronitis, acute herpetic gingivostomatitis, acute necrotizing ulcerative gingivitis, acute periapical infection. Treatment should be delayed because of bacteremia and diffuse of infection in deeper tissue. With this, we complete the contraindication of tooth extraction. Thank you.